Superinfections pose threat to severely ill coronavirus patients. Superinfections are posing a threat to coronavirus patients, with many dying because of these secondary superimposed bacterial infections and not solely because of viral infection. The Seattle Times describes the complication of these superinfections as a silent component of cases and deaths because they aren't always given attention. Sometimes, the treatments patients take for their primary infection do not work on their superinfections. Though scientists are still struggling to fully understand the novel coronavirus and COVID-19, many are worried that superinfections may play a larger role than they realize. Julie Gerberding said, up to 50% of the deaths of people hospitalized on ventilators so far are actually a consequence of bacterial superinfections. Gerberding is a former director of the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention and the president of Merck's Vaccine Division. She called bacterial superinfections a force of mortality that should be given more attention, considering that the most critical ill coronavirus patients are unable to fight infections easily, leaving them vulnerable to further infection. Gerberding said they often have not only ventilation tubes but other catheters and devices that set the stage for hospital bacteria to start infections. As these severely ill coronavirus patients stay confined for long periods, there is more time for their bodies to come into contact with bacteria that don't always respond to antibiotics. Superinfections are already hard to treat on their own, but another problem is that many hospitals lack the antibiotics necessary to hand out to patients. The CDC defines superinfections as infections that follow a previous infection, especially when caused by microorganisms that are resistant or have become resistant to the antibiotics used earlier. Co-infections, on the other hand, occur at the same time as the initial infection. According to medical news site MedPage Today, around 10% to 30% of hospitalized, severely ill coronavirus patients acquire secondary infections, but it is more common in ICUs. Severely ill coronavirus patients are also 10 times more likely to have bacterial or fungal secondary infections than viral secondary infections. Recent mouse studies have suggested that interferon-based coronavirus drugs may increase patients' susceptibility to bacterial infections, but these have yet to be investigated closely. Andreas Wach, senior author of one of the interferon studies, said, "Even when we find a vaccine, the COVID story will not end because they may be long-term effects."